Today is World Kidney Day, and March is Kidney Awareness Month. We're learning more about support networks for both kidney donors and recipients.
Lori Hartwell of the Renal Support Network joins us now. Welcome, Lori.
Hi, thanks for having me.
So what is this Renal Support Network? What do you do?
Well, it's an organization I founded because I had kidney failure at the age of 2. And my goal is to really help when you've been diagnosed with kidney disease, have the emotional support and peer support to help you live with an illness.
One of the events you have is the teen prom, which you were telling me you do every January, I guess.
Yes, over Martin Luther King weekend. And, you know, I never went to my own prom because I spent all my teenage years on dialysis. So I wanted to create this a special event for teens with kidney disease so they could connect with their peers, get to know each other, and have a memorable night.
And this year you had a pretty special prom king, didn't you?
Yes, Jack Black has attended our prom for the last 3 years. And he makes the teens feel so special. And this year we named him King of the Prom.
So these are all kids with who have kidney disease?
Yes, they're either on dialysis or they've received a transplant. And, you know, chronic kidney disease, there's no cure. So, you know, I've had a transplant and that doesn't mean I'm cured. So I'm really here to bring awareness about, you know, kidney disease and, you know, who is at risk.
Who is at risk? What are the risk factors?
Well, you know, anybody who has high blood pressure or diabetes, that's the two number one causes of kidney failure. And according to the Center for Disease Control, 1 in 6 people are at risk. So I always say, you know, buy one of those cheap blood pressure machines and make sure you know your blood pressure. Take your medications. If you have diabetes, make sure you manage your blood sugar. And just, you know, be aware that your kidneys are a very important thing because when they don't work, your life can be crazy.
And one of the statistics I saw about this is that half the people who are in early stages of this don't know it.
They don't because it's kind of a silent illness. When you have high blood pressure, I had a friend of mine who, you know, basically had headaches. And, his blood pressure was high and his kidneys ended up failing as a result of that. And he didn't know till he was in the emergency room. So I really encourage people to know their blood pressure, you know, ask your doctor to check your kidneys. There's a test called glomerular filtration rate, GFR, to know what it is. And, you know, you can do a lot of things to prevent chronic kidney disease or prevent the delay of severe kidney failure.
And is that something that they would normally pick up in a regular blood scan if I go for my yearly physical?
Yes, it is. But, you know, as somebody who's lived with kidney disease and been kind of a healthcare advocate my whole life, you have to stay on top of your own labs. You have to read them. You have to ask the doctor. So don't expect that the doctor is going to always alert you to things because just from experience. So you have to be your own advocate.
And Lori, you mentioned that there are things that we can do to prevent this. What should we be doing?
Well, the two number one things is to, you know, do everything to keep your blood pressure in control. And, you know, if you have any signs of diabetes or if, you know, if your family's had diabetes or high blood pressure, you're more likely to have that. So it's really important to know about that. There's other causes of kidney failure. My failure was caused from E. coli bacteria when I was a little girl. So there's other risk factors that, you know, can happen to have your kidneys fail. But the most important thing is, you know, maintain a good weight, you know, exercise, keep your blood pressure in control. You know, we're a very stressed out society, so it's very easy to have high blood pressure and you don't know it. The problem is you don't feel high blood pressure. You might have a headache. You know, you think, oh, I'm looking at the computer too much. No, check your blood pressure. Make sure you know what it is and take your medication if you have high blood pressure.
Well, you said that you're a transplant patient, and is it a long wait now? Are there enough donors out there?
No. It's an incredible wait. Right now in Los Angeles for a kidney, it's about a 7 to 9 year wait.
Oh, my goodness.
Wow. And in the country, there's over, you know, 110,000 people waiting for a life-saving organ. So I always, you know, sign your donor card. There's a website called DonateLifeCalifornia.org. You can decide to be an organ donor. But also, I received a kidney from my stepsister a year ago. And you can also be a living donor. And I like to give, you know, credit to those people who stepped up and donated a kidney because it definitely made a huge difference in my life. And I'm very grateful.
All right. And we're grateful for the work you're doing. Lori, thank you.
Thanks, Lori.
Thank you so much.